The differences between HBase and Cassandra. So these are two important NoSQL databases. A lot of companies compare before deciding one option out of these two. So HBase is having CP as important feature out of CAP theorem. So in CAP theorem, we have consistency, availability, and partition tolerance. So if you see CAP theorem, just quick recap of CAP theorem. So this is consistency, availability, and partition tolerance. So consistency says that all clients will have same view of the data. Availability says that your system is always available. If you send any request to the system, then it will always respond with success or failure. Partition tolerance means even if there are network failures, then also your system will be working fine. So HBase is giving importance to CP out of these three. So CAP theorem says that out of these three factors, only two can be possible at a time. So HBase gives importance to consistency and partition tolerance, and Cassandra gives importance to AP, availability and partition tolerance. So data may not be consistent, so that's why it is AP. It can tolerate partition failures and it is basically highly available. So that's the idea behind Cassandra in general. This CAP theorem, how does it map? That's very important difference. So when you need use case like Facebook Messenger messaging use case requires 100% consistency, because when you are sending a message from one client to another client, then all the people in the group, let's say we are having some group conversation, and in that group conversation, when you are exchanging messages, then all people in that group conversation, all clients will have same view of the data, which is very important. But if you talk about Cassandra, this is an example of Facebook likes. So even if my like will propagate 2 minutes late from San Francisco data center to Singapore data center, no problem. It does not impact me as such. So that's why this is example of Facebook likes. So Cassandra was basically developed at Facebook, and this was the intention behind that. So a lot of open source engineers were actually working on Cassandra from Facebook also. And both these things are Java based, and both these storage technologies are inspired by Google's Bigtable white paper. Apart from that, both these technologies fall under the similar category, column family category in NoSQL databases. So there are a lot of similarities also, but I am right now mentioning the differences. So this one is master worker architecture. And Cassandra is peer-to-peer architecture. So HBase works in one data center. Usually you will find is preferred. Reason being, it's a master worker architecture. And whenever we are having master worker architecture, the heartbeat takes time to propagate. If you are having one master in one data center and another and we have workers in some other data centers, then the heartbeat will take time to propagate from worker to master, and there will be timeouts. So we will consider the workers are dead. So there will be issues related to this. So that's why it's recommended to use one data center. But in Cassandra, it's not master worker. It is fine to use multiple data centers are supported. Apart from that, in HBase, Hadoop is required, because H means Hadoop and base means database, so you have HDFS. But nowadays S3 is also okay. I've seen like some companies using HBase on S3, but those are very rare implementations. But S3 also fine. These are rare, but mostly you will find Hadoop is must. Apart from that, here there is no Hadoop dependency as such. when you are working in HBase, you don't have any SQL query language, so no query language. No query language available. So what are the options when you don't have query language? You can use Phoenix, Apache Phoenix, over HBase, or you can use Impala over HBase, Impala slash Hive slash Spark SQL over HBase. So there are multiple options that we can use when we don't have query language. So this will provide us query language support. And this is much, much faster than other options because this is a thin skin over HBase. Phoenix is very thin, very lightweight skin over HBase to provide SQL interface. But here we have SQL, Cassandra query language. And apart from that, we have support for coprocessors. Triggers, observers. So basically, HBase provides you this option to write code in region server JVM, which is like you can write your own custom logic, stored procedure kind of functionality or triggers kind of functionality in HBase, but it is not there in Cassandra. So this is recommended for write heavy applications. Write heavy apps, for example Facebook Messenger, and this one is for read intensive and large scale reads are required. Apart from that, Cassandra has less setup overhead, but HBase requires a lot of setup. So HBase is promoted by Cloudera and earlier a lot of other companies like Hortonworks was also giving support, but Cassandra is supported by DataStax primarily, you will find. So that is the enterprise support that you can get from DataStax. So hope this gives you idea like what is the difference between HBase and Cassandra and which one to choose when.